There is perhaps nothing scarier than slowly losing all of your memories, except maybe that the process might start at a much younger age than you think. Hey guys, Amy here with you on DNews today. Scientists don't really understand what causes Alzheimer's disease, but ongoing research has uncovered that its onset is rooted in a complex series of events that take place in the brain over a long period of time. Contributing factors include genetic, environmental, and lifestyle factors, but because everyone is genetically different and lives a very different life, preventing the onset of Alzheimer's varies from person to person. One hallmark of Alzheimer's is amyloid. Amyloid is an abnormal protein usually produced in the bone marrow that can sometimes be deposited in other tissues and organs, and it has been found to accumulate in clumps outside neurons in older adults, as well as in Alzheimer's patients. These clumps typically damage and eventually kill memory-related neurons, because when neurons are exposed to these kinds of clumps, it triggers an excess leakage of calcium into the cells that kills them. The clumps can also secrete amyloid outside the cell, leading to the plaque buildup that's commonly associated with Alzheimer's. This finding comes from a new study at the Northwestern University's Feinberg School of Medicine. For the study, the team was interested in neurons in the basal forebrain closely involved in memory and attention, to try to understand why they can be damaged early and why they tend to be the first to die. They examined these neurons in the brains of three groups of deceased individuals: cognitively normal young people between the ages of 20 and 66, non-demented older people between the ages of 70 and 99, and individuals affected by Alzheimer's between the ages of 60 and 95. They found that the amyloid molecules weren't present exclusively in Alzheimer's patients. They were present in normal young adults as well. Once present, the amyloid molecules can continue to grow over the course of an individual's lifetime, ultimately growing to be quite large in older individuals and those with Alzheimer's. It explains why these neurons die early. The lifelong accumulation of toxic amyloid likely contributes to their vulnerability in both natural aging and loss in Alzheimer's. The team plans to investigate how internal amyloid damages the neurons as its next stage of research. So it's a small step, but hopefully the research can someday lead to the science that brings us closer to prevention or a cure. So does this new discovery make you more or less concerned about developing Alzheimer's? Let us know in the comments below, or you can find me and tell me on Twitter as AstVintageSpace. And don't forget to subscribe right here for more DNews every day of the week. Thanks for watching.